Now, this one here is a track from my most recent album, which is called Guitar Music, and it's a tune written by a great English guitarist named Davy Graham. It's called Angie, and it became the piece to play in the folk scene back in the 60s in England, apparently. Ralph Mattel told me once that if you could play Angie, you'd get a gig in England. So, hence, all the folkies had a go at playing it. And it's not that easy to play, but it was made famous by a guy called Bert Jansch, another great guitar player, and then a little bit later on, Paul Simon did a version of it on the first Simon & Garfunkel album. And he would have learned that when he was doing the rounds of the folk clubs in England. You might know it, it's called Angie, it's a beautiful thing to play. I never really get tired of playing this one, so it's on Guitar Music. Cheers. That's Angie. Great fun to play for a guitar player. Apparently he sort of started to get that idea when he was working out how to play Hit the Road Jack. There you go. So history tells us. Okay, now I just heard that the next couple of weeks you've got Bill Jackson coming here. Now Bill and I've known Bill for many years and we wrote a few songs together, and this is one that we wrote and I actually recorded on my album The River Flows. He's probably playing with Karen Tolhurst, another great muso. So anyway, this song's called The Things That You Want. There's a light on the sea, it's not far from your reach. It's all that you crave, it's all that you seek and hold. All that you pray come true. Sometimes the things you want drift away from you. And these dreams that you hold are the cards you can play. You can deal your hearts or fold them away and wait. Wait till your hand is true. And sometimes the things you want drift away from you. There are moments in time when the sailor sings, the seas are calm and your ship will come in. And these times are far and few. And sometimes the things you want will drift their way to you. These dreams I hold dear keep me searching the shore. The tides will rise and the seas return once more. The light slips away from you. Sometimes the things you want drift their way to you. Sometimes the things you want drift away from you. And sometimes the things you want drift their way to you. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was The Things You Want. And what I really like is to take this sound system on the road. Thanks, Pikey. I really would. Believe me, folks, it's not like this every night. This is absolutely fabulous tonight. Put your hands together for this gentleman over here. Yeah, indeed, it's good. Oh, lovely. Actually sounds like a guitar on stage. Sometimes you'd be surprised. I was just looking at Little Green Man running up there, and I was watching an interview with Eric Clapton a few months ago, and of course he plays the Royal Albert Hall a lot, and he said, you walk out on stage and it's pitch black. Like, from up here I can't see anybody, right? But he says he gets quite nervous when he walks out. It's just Clapton, of course. And he knows there's thousands of people there, but all down into of the Royal Albert Hall, he can see the Little Green Man on the wall. And he says he focuses on that. He plays to the Little Green Man. Keeps him, you know, on the straight and the level. So There you go. That's what you like to hear, that story. The Green Man. Running away from something. Always running away from something. I know how he feels. This one's called The Victory Rag. And have pity on me because I'm a lifelong St Kilda supporter. And we're doing really well at the moment. And this tune was probably written the last time we won a grand final. Long, long time ago. It's called a victory rag. Rag time. Cheers. All right, moving right along here. Now, I play, I play with a fine musician named Liz Frencham. You've probably seen her if you've been to Port Fairy. Great bass player, singer-songwriter. She actually has played on quite a number of my albums and we've done a lot of gigs over the years. But she wrote this lovely song called Wine. And I liked it so much I recorded it myself. And I had the opportunity to play on her album doing it too. Sort of a sad drinking song, this one. This is called Wine. Lift that window off the wall, roll it up like a canvas. An old lack of reality, it's more than I can handle. Lock the chimney, bolt the door, and pull the phone from the socket. Pass that bottle off the shelf and make way for the ruby red rocket. Wine, 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 nothing sweeter than wine. Wine, 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 so divine. A magic brew, a tonic too. Let's drink from the rose-colored glass. Watch that circus come to town. Pray that the music lasts. Problems, they will fade away. Let's drink till the blues get gone. And hoping that they won't be back in the cold gray light of dawn. Wine, 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 nothing sweeter than wine. Wine, 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 so divine. tasting sour. A razor shoved in the brain, the empty bottle mocks me, but I know that I can't complain. I'll wait a while till the evening smiles, but I know that it won't be long before I lose myself inside that crimson siren song. Wine, 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 nothing sweeter than wine. Wine, 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 so divine. Wine, 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 so divine. Wine, 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 so divine. Thank you. That's wine. One of my inspirations as an early inspirations as a fingerstyle player was a wonderful guitarist named John Fay, and he referred to himself as the American primitive, and kind of rediscovering a lot of the old fingerstyle techniques of the early blues guys and so on. And this is one of his kind of more famous pieces, and I recorded this one on Guitar Music as well. This one's called The Last Steam Engine Train. Thank you. That's The Last Steam Engine Train. Right. Now here's one that many of you will know, I hope. And this was a hit in the late 50s, early 60s. There was a duo named Santo and Johnny. you. The Sleeple. Cheers. Anybody remember that one? Good. That's good. When I first started playing guitar, my very first guitar teacher was a guy named Les Adams. He was a steel guitarist, and he had the Australian hit single of that in 1959. And I remember he played it for me at my first guitar lesson, and I was impressed. I only wanted to know about Hendrix and Clapton at the time, but anyway, looking back on it, it's a great tune. Anyway, here's a bit of blues for you. This is also my new album. It's by one of my blues heroes, the great Mississippi John Hurt. This is Monday Morning Blues. I woke up this morning with the Monday morning blues. I could hardly find, I could hardly find the Monday morning shoes. Monday morning blues right down to my bones. I've been laying in jail 6 long weeks today. Well, tomorrow morning gonna be my trial day. I'm gonna ask the judge what might be my crime. Get a pick and shovel and head down to the mine. That's the only time I ever felt like crying. Monday morning blues right down to my bones. That's right. Thank you. Monday Morning Blues. Thank you. I think it might be time for a Bob Dylan song. Oh, Bob, he's written a few beauties. This one goes way back to early Dylan. And I think really when I... My memory is that it's probably on that maybe second or maybe the third album. And on that album, the song's called One Too Many Mornings. It doesn't actually sound like he's finished it. It's such a good little idea. He kind of whacked it down and they put it out. And it just sounds like he's... Kind of makes sort of see him sniggering to himself, like, take that one, you know. I was watching one the other day who was playing at Newport Folk Festival 1963 and he's doing A Hard Rain's Gonna Fall. And check this video out sometime. Pete Seeger's sitting on a chair next to him tapping his foot like this. There's always other folk singers watching. And Dylan starts to play A Hard Rain. It's just come out and they're all gobsmacked by it, you know. And he starts to channel these lyrics. Apparently he used to do it quite a lot in those days. He gets into the middle of the song and he makes up some new verses. And they're amazing, you know, and it's the only time I've ever heard some of these verses. And I think he was doing that in the studio at the time. And anyway, many people did cover this song in the early days and kind of finished it off. And I kind of contributed to the story of this song. It's called One Too Many Mornings and A Thousand Miles Behind. Dogs are barking, the day is getting dark. The night comes in a falling, and the dogs will lose their bark. And the silent night will shatter from the sounds inside my mind. And I'm one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind. Crossroads on my doorstep, my eyes they start to fade. As I turn my head back to the room where my love and I have laid. And I gaze back to the street, to the sidewalk and the sign. And I'm one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind. Restless, hungry feeling that don't mean no one no good. And everything I'm saying, you can say it just as good. You're right from your side, and I'm right from mine. We're both one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind. We're both one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind. More this set. I have a very short break and I can't see what my watch says anyway without my glasses on. You know, I used to be able to read lyric charts on the floor back in the day. Imagine that. Anyway. You know, folk singers famously always had lyrics on stage and on music stands. And an English student of mine, a guitar player the other day, told me a folky joke. He said, why does a folk singer have his eyes closed when he's singing? Because he's got the lyrics written under his eyelids. Okay. Not bad, really. So this one's called Penelope. That's on my album, The River Flows. And I have brand new copies of that, hot off the press. It's rather, on the recording, it's rather a long instrumental, features a really fine lap steel solo. A mate of mine named Pete Fiddler. This is the a version of the tune Penelope. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, I'll do one more. We'll have a little bit of a break. Come over there if we want to have a bit of a chat and have a look at the albums and stuff. Grab a glass of wine or whatever. And this is one that's been with me for many, many, many years. And I don't know how many times I've played it, but someone always asks for it, so I don't even wait for that anymore, just play it anyway. It's by the great Peter Green, one of my favourite guitarists, and it's on my album that's called New Kind of Feeling, and you'll know it, it's called Albatross. Short break now, folks. Yes. Bit of 12 string. I've been tuning it all day, so I might as well play it. Thank you. Thank you very much. I might do another one of these since I got it out. That was called Rib Cracker. And I had that tune written for quite a while and had no name. And good friends of ours had one of these great dogs called a Rhodesian Ridgeback, which is about that high. And he took it for a walk one day, and it took him for a walk instead. And he broke a couple of ribs, and, which wasn't funny, but, you know, he had a bit of a laugh about it at the time. And so I call that tune Rib Cracker in honour of that particular moment. This one's called Heart Starter. Thank you. very much. That's how I feel some mornings. I always love that tune, that Spanish Harlem, that's on my album Grace Notes. Yeah. Big fan of the Drifters. Here's a song that's I wrote with my sister. It's about her mother. And she was born in the northern New South Wales town of Tinga on the Gwydra in the New England Plateau. 1928, to be precise, and in those days it was really out there in the sticks. And this is a little song about her life journey. In the northern town of Tinga, there are streets where the cattle roam. If you choose to linger, you'll find my mother's home. And there the streets are named for jewels, and the golden wattle grows in the wilds of New England where the Gwydra flows. In dreams she walks o'er tiled streets where the old house shines a light. See the dusty haze on the summer days and the stars of a Tinga night. But the road to the city's calling, and the harbour bridge looks down on the blue-eyed girl from Tinga and Sydney Town. And there the streets are named for heroes, and the houses cram and crush. The sunlight peers through the dust of years and the crazy rush. In dreams she walks o'er childhood streets where the old house shines a light. See the dusty haze on the summer days and the stars. For Tinga night. But sorrow flies through windows and Sydney fades away. The blue-eyed girl from Tinga looks for a better day. Oh, this Tinga girl still dreaming of a life ahead still fair. The journey's on and the life's a song in the Melbourne air. Here the streets are broad and stately, the sun shines through the trees. I've been thinking of you lately, and a love that came to please. And how you played piano softly on those Sunday afternoons. The melody would grace the air with those sad old tunes. In dreams she walks those childhood streets where the old house shines a light. See the dusty haze on the summer days and the stars of a Tinga night. They say life's a journey. Yes, it's true that life is long. My country girl from Tinga, our celebrating song. Moving right along now, and this is the blues called Watching Billy Play the Blues. Billy was a guitar player we met in Tasmania and Hobart, actually, and one of the musicians, his name's Billy Whitten. So I wrote this little blues for him called Watching Billy Play the Blues. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yes. Watching Billy play the blues. And moving on to a blues song of mine. This one's called Three Lines Deep and 12 Bars Long. Tilted King launched a thousand ships, threw his will away for a stolen kiss. I never saw the light, never heard the song. I'm three lines deep and 12 bars long. Come all you saints and sinners, learned and fools, I read the stars and the signs for clues, with an ear to the ground, found a song. And three lines deep and 12 bars long. Three lines deep and 3 lines deep. Three lines deep and 12 bars long. Troubled souls have been torn apart to find a cure for the broken heart. How can a man prove to be so wrong? Well, it's three lines deep and 12 bars long. Three lines deep. Deep and 3 lines deep and 12 bars long. And 3 lines deep and 3 lines deep and 3 lines deep and 12 bars long. Thank you. Thank you very much, folks. Good. 3 lines deep, 12 bars long. A couple more here for you before we wind things up. And it's been great to come and play for you. Hope you've had a good evening. I've loved playing this room. It's a beautiful room. Thanks to David, and thanks again to Pikey Doe and the sound. And put your hands together for those two guys. And everyone else involved too. It's a wonderful thing. Please spread the word and keep these kinds of things going. Now we did a lot of touring before the pandemic, and a lot of trips to America. 13 tours, 300 gigs in the US. That's a lot of cheese. a lot of really bad coffee. Some good coffee. But many times we played, toured in the southwest and went through Arizona and New Mexico. And one of the first gigs I ever did in America was in the town of Las Cruces on the Rio Grande. And I've got fond memories of that place. A beautiful part of the US in the Rio Grande Valley. And this is Las Cruces.
Thank you.